Hello everyone. I get asked all the time, what are the best projects for building up your resume and getting a job? So in this video, I'm going to give you 5 projects that you can build in a single week that are going to drastically improve your resume and give you great odds at getting your first job or your next job. So let's get started now. Welcome back to Web Dev Simplified. My name's Kyle, and my job is to simplify the web for you so you can start building your dream project sooner. So if that sounds interesting, make sure you subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this one. Now, to get started with the very first project that you're going to want to do, this is going to be building out any form of web application that consumes some third-party API. So just find an API that interests you. Maybe it's a food cooking API, maybe it's a movie API, maybe it's the API for your favorite game, and you want to build a website that consumes that API and displays some form of data, does some CRUD operations, whatever it is. You just want to make sure that this site that you create is consuming some third-party API. Now, this is a great project because almost every single company that you work for is going to use an API at some point, whether it's going to be a web API or a library or some other type of API. They are going to consume an API from someone else, and you are going to need to do that integration. So showing that you can create a web application entirely built around integrating with an already existing API is a great skill set to have. And best of all, this is actually a really easy project to do because you don't need to build out a complex backend since the API that you're using takes care of all of that for you. You get to really focus on making an engaging, interesting user experience and user interface while having only maybe a little bit of backend work needed if the API requires that, but some APIs don't even need you to use a backend. So this is a great entry-level project that shows employers that you know how to use APIs, and that is super important for getting a job. Now that you've built out this site using an API, the next site you should create is going to be a brochure site. And this can be any type of site, for example, a landing page for a restaurant. This could be an artist page for showing off their work. A lot of times this is going to be a site that showcases a business. It's going to be like a landing page, contact page. And you're also going to most likely have some other thing like a portfolio or a menu based on what the actual business is that you're going for. And this doesn't have to be a legit business. You don't need to find a business to build this site for. You can build it for an existing business if you want for your own purposes, make up a business and build it for it. Really, this site is to show that you're able to make an appealing, engaging, and high-converting landing page so that when people come to this landing page, they know exactly what it is, they know what this restaurant is selling, they know where it's located, they know how to contact them, they can look at the menu, and make it look really visually pleasing. You want people to be amazed when they go to the website, you want the experience to be really good, so this is focused entirely on making the front-end user interface and user experience really, really good. This is your ability to showcase how good you are at making a front-end website. And the best part is, all the time, you're going to be working for companies that need a landing page. They need that front-end exposure. They need to have something like a barbershop. They need a website. Tons of companies need these really simple front-end only websites. So showing that you have the ability to make these websites is going to make you incredibly marketable, not only in freelance, but also for getting a job, since companies just need this technology and need these skills. So this is a great project that's really easy to do and can be completed in even just a single weekend if you really put your time and effort into it. And you can expand this and make it as complex and amazing as you want, or you can keep it relatively simple if you're not as good at the front end. So this is a great secondary project to work on. For this third project, we're going to finally jump from the front end and go over into the back end. And the idea of this project is to create an e-commerce site. And this doesn't have to be a complex e-commerce site. You don't want to make Amazon. You don't want to make anything crazy like eBay. This is going to be really, really simple. Imagine that previous example of the brochure site. Now imagine that you have an artist brochure site and you want to be able to sell their different paintings and their different work. You can integrate a really simple e-commerce solution into this platform where they're able to select things such as paintings or t-shirts, and then it'll send that to the backend, make the payments and processing, and send back saying that they've made the purchase, and that you handle all of that stuff, such as inventory and all of that, on the backend. With this simple approach, you don't need any type of user authentication system. All you need is the basic interface between a shop on the front end and how that's processed on the backend, so you can make this a really simple project that you can complete in just a single week. But if you want to take it a step further, really make this a wow project, maybe you're more focused on the backend and less on the frontend, you can go all the way and do user authentication, for example, and really make a complex inventory system, a shopping cart system. You can really take this project from a week-long project to a month-long project, or even longer if you really want to make it a wow project on your resume. But just that week-long version where you have a simple e-commerce site that allows you to make payments, make purchases, send that confirmation to the user, just kind of let them know that everything's working, that shows employers that you know how to work with e-commerce, because most companies you work for are selling something online, so they need to know that you are able to handle selling things online. Not only that, but companies are always concerned about security, so if you're able to make a good e-commerce platform, it shows that you're able to make a secure web application since you have a trustworthy e-commerce platform, and that is something that is most important to be secure. It shows that you know how to handle payments, how to handle security, and possibly even user authentication if you throw that into this project. And it's a great way to show them that you're able to do exactly what they want you to do and that you have all these additional backend and front-end skills. The fourth project on this list is, in my opinion, the most enjoyable, and that is to build out your own portfolio site. Now that you've created a couple projects, the first, second, and third project, you need a place to showcase these projects so that people know what you've built and they want to be able to check it out. So this is where you create your own portfolio site where you have information about yourself, your skills, your resume, as well as all of these other projects that you've created. So you have one central place to send people when you're applying for jobs. This also is the page where you can do the most with creativity and visual design, because you want to make this look as appealing as possible, as creative as possible. Really, you can throw your own personality into this site, which makes it really fun since you can do all these crazy animations and cool stuff like that. But you can also make it really appealing to the user. You want this to look the best, because when you are applying for jobs, the first people to look at your resume are almost always going to be HR or non-technical people. So having that really flashy, good-looking website that they say, wow, this person knows how to make cool-looking, good websites, that's incredibly important. So make sure you spend a lot of time on the front end of your portfolio and make it look really, really appealing. This is where I find it to be the most fun, because you have a ton of creativity with what you do with this project. Now, the last project on this list, number 5, is also really fun to work with, and this is to create a really simple game. Now, I'm not talking that you need to go out and build the next World of Warcraft or crazy huge game. I'm talking something really small and simple, like make chess, for example, or checkers, or a simple board game where all of the rules are already defined. One of the hardest parts about game development is planning out all the rules, making all the art. So if you're able to take a game that already exists, like chess or checkers, take all the art that already exists, and just build out the rules that already exist, that'll save you a ton of time and make it so this project can be built in just a single week. I also highly recommend you work with a multiplayer version of the game. So for example, a tic-tac-toe two-person game across the internet or chess across the internet. And this is because that allows you to do front-end skills and back-end skills with WebSocket communication between them in real time, all in one project. And it's also something that if you do something like chess or checkers, is relatively easy to do and can be done in a single week. But the best part is these types of projects look really impressive. Having a fully built out two-player chess online looks amazing to an employer and shows them that you not only know how to build out projects, you know how to do the back end, you know how to do the front end, but you also know how to reliably communicate in real time between the front end and the back end. It also shows that you know how to polish a project, because game development is mostly about polishing. The game building part takes a while, but actually polishing that last 10-20% of game development takes just as long as building the entire game. So showing that you're able to do that and finish a project is a crucial skill to have, and employers absolutely love that. And this is another project, like the e-commerce one, where you can take it and make it as long as you want. You could make a simple game in a week, and then you could expand upon that game and make it take weeks or months or as long as you want if this is something that interests you and a project that you want to make your wow factor on your resume. Now, you may be thinking that these projects are too easy or not important or not going to get you a job, but I can assure you, when I applied for jobs, I had 3 of these 5 projects complete and it absolutely wowed my employers that were looking at my resume. I always got told that the projects on my resume were the number one reason for why people kept asking me for interviews and giving me job offers. It was purely based on these projects I created, and I'm telling you, 3 out of the 5 projects on this list I had on my resume, and it really, really helped me get my first job. So if you haven't already, get out there and start building at least one of these projects. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out my other videos linked over here and subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this one. Thank you very much for watching and have a good day.